I've been called over again by my dad this time, and I've looked at it, and it's definitely either a grow or a half grow, and it is a stunner, especially once he cleans it up. So if we take a closer look,
that's it.
Yeah, that is stunning.
Do you want to flip it over on the other side?
Could zoom in a tiny bit. Yeah.
See the cross there on the pellets?
So, do you want to get some water on that?
It's lovely
then?
And flat, look at that.
Yeah. Perfect.
Alright, I'll just get in the water. Oh, that is looking lovely. Look at that.
What a stunner of a coin.
Oh, that's a beauty. That's a beauty. Look at that.
Oh, beautiful.
I think it's a groat.
Yeah. Definitely, I think. Cool. Do you want to face it around so we can see the bust on it? Look at that. That is a stunning coin. Beautiful.
That's not bad, is it?
No.
It was just under the surface. Banging signal, scraped the surface, and it was just laying there.
God.
Look at that.
That is absolutely stunning.
It's just been clipped on this one edge, so
yeah.
Around here, you can see the right, but around here, it's been, on this side, it's been clipped.
Yeah.
But around here's fine, so looking at the size of that, if it hadn't been clipped, I'd say that's a groat.
Yeah.
I think it's a groat.
Well,
I'm really pleased with that.
That is a pretty good start on this field, so I guess we're going to have to carry on and grid this area if coins like that are coming up. So, well done. That is beautiful.
Well done.
Yeah.
Holy moly, I just don't believe it. I mean, I was always the luckiest person at school, luckiest person ever. I started detecting, I was the luckiest person, find stuff. Now, Julie's just taken my crown. She is so jammy.
Honestly.
She's got more jam than Hartley's, I tell you this now. Unbelievable. She has just found
something
I've seen brooches, but this is a Roman brooch. It is a monster of a brooch, and I will show you. Here she comes. Let's have a look.
Like it before.
Let's come down here.
It's really lumpy.
Very lumpy, yeah.
On ankle break of mud here, but
let's get the sun on it. Look at the size of that brooch.
It's weird. It's really weird.
That is the strangest looking brooch I've ever seen. It's almost
possibly
looking like Celtic. I don't know. It's very strange.
Yeah.
It's a strange design. It's monstrous. It's a monstrous. Turn it around the side.
That is amazing.
No, so it's this side.
Oh, sorry.
I want to see the whole thing. Look at that. I mean,
it's a stunner of a brooch, either way. But yeah, it's a pretty weird design.
Look at it. I mean, it's a fibula brooch, but it's a fibula brooch with bits on it that I've never seen. So bits of design, really strange. You look at these two flat bits here. These bits here, just here. They almost look Saxon, you see on Saxon brooches. But then you look at these bits here, they look like bunches of grapes. And you look at these bobbly bits at the back here.
Yeah.
Look at them bobbles. I mean,
that's sort of the
that's weird.
Between Celtic and Roman, I would say. But.
So you've got weird bobbly bits here, you've got some straight plate bits here that look almost like Saxon, and then you've got this strange grapey design on there.
Yeah.
I mean, and look at that. What a stunning brooch.
I'm so happy with
whoever
that.
Wore that on their toga, well, it must have weighed them down. They must have walked along a bit, lopsided, because the weight of that brooch on one shoulder, they must have had two of them, equal them up. It's monstrous. It is a monster brooch.
That is an amazing brooch.
It's a monster brooch.
And
it's a design I have never, ever, ever seen in any magazine.
No.
Or anything before.
Never
it's like,
seen anything like
it's
it.
Almost like whoever designed that, whoever made that, had a bit of a moment. He thought, what can I put on this brooch? You know, he's shoved so many bits of design on there, different strange, I don't know, things that he's he's had a bit of a...
A moment.
A bit of a moment there making that. He's thought, what can I make that's going to be the most outlandish, wackiest brooch ever?
The Liberace brooches.
It is.
Well, what a find, though. That is an amazing find.
It's mental. Well, do you know what that means? That is definitely high status.
Yeah.
That is high status. Whoever wore that certainly was chief. So we're going to have a look around here for some more, because there's got to be more here. So, righto. Well done. Well done, Jamie. Brilliant.
Okay, Liam's called me over.
Right, we've been searching for most of the day now. I've called her over, and I've had a really nice coin. And it's a first for me as well. So, let's have a look.
Let's see what we got.
Went closer.
It's very windy, so I'm apologising
really for sheltered.
Liam's
So hopefully you can see that. We've messaged some friends and they've come back to us and they've said it's a dual cross hammered Saxon coin. So that's a first for me, and that looks like it's going to clean up really nice.
It's
a real shame, but it doesn't matter because that is a stunning coin. Don't want to go in too close, otherwise you might. So you can see a little pellet in the middle, like with a circle, and then the dual cross, sort of icing around the edge. So that is stunning. I haven't cleaned the other side too much at the moment. I'm going to do that when I get home. I don't want to rub it.
It's brittle.
Yeah, exactly.
We've been here before.
So, yeah, first for me, and I'm so happy with that. That is fantastic. So it's either half a canute, Harold, so Harold the first or second, I'm not entirely sure yet. But that is stunning. I'm so happy with that.
I've been searching
all day. It's taken, I've worked for it, I really have.
I've found nothing but buttons and lead all day.
Fantastic. Yeah, I suppose.
Well done.
But yeah, we can't carry on now anyway because it's getting dark.
It's starting to get dark, it's home time now.
But that is stunning. So we'll have a description on it later in the video. So yeah.
Well done.
Let's carry on.
Righto, out on a club digger day, not the best of conditions, all stubble, but beggars can't be choosers. But I've come to a field where I know I've had a few hammered before, and other club members have had some nice hammered, including a nice big shilling up this area, and I've just stepped up into this area and I had a whacking signal, and there you go, look, still in the clod. Look at that. That looks lovely. Looks like a full coin as well. It's got a shield on there, as you can see. Just zoom in a bit. And it's got a date there, 1565, is that? Looks like 1565. So that's going to be an Elizabeth sixpence. Clearly read the date, look at that. Perfect. Right, so let's get it out. See what we got, eh? Hopefully the bust is a nice bust. Let's break the mud away. Oh, look at that. Beauty. Looks like it's not been clipped hardly at all. Maybe a little bit on the bottom end. Lovely coin. Look at that. Hopefully she's just come out there. Nice, pull it out. Oh, look at that. What a coin. Beauty. What's on the other side? Oh, it's all a bit muddy. Right, I'm not going to rub this. All I'm going to do is I'm going to wash this. Take a few photographs. I'm going to wash the back end. And I'll be back. See what it's like. But that side's beautiful. Righto, give it a little washing water, and look at that, reverse side, look absolutely stunning, look at that, 1568 it is actually. Let me zoom in, try and zoom in on the date, and get it focused, come on, there you go, look, 1568,
bit of a weird eight, but definitely 1568. It's got a crown mint mark, looks like. So beautiful coin. Clean them out a bit. But on the reverse side, the obverse side, sorry. Look at that. Unfortunately, it's a bit blank really. Can't really see a lot there. Turn it round. Can in a certain light you can see it, look. Just see a bust. Just see it there. So it's not too bad. Would have been nice if it was a bit sharper. But still a full coin. Look at that, beautiful. That's lovely. Absolutely beautiful. Right. Okay. Let's see if we can get some more in. See you later. I don't believe it. Look at the smile on her face. It is pissing the rain, and yet she's smiling. And I can't believe it. We walked into an area, we found a bit of pottery, and I said, there is Roman stuff here. There's, and I found a bit of samian ware.
We found 2 bits of grey ware, and a bit of samian ware. So we've concentrated. Nick just found a cistercius, and now I've just dug a hole.
Oh my
that's only
God.
4 inches deep, and I saw silver.
And she's found a denarius.
It's raining. So
Jesus Christ. Let's have a zoom in on that.
It is raining.
Oh, my times. Focus, it's hard.
Yeah,
look at that.
That's going to clean up an absolute beauty.
So it looks like Faustina, doesn't it?
I think it's a Stina, so yes. I think it is a Faustina.
Zoom a little bit further. Try and get it to zoom. Come on, focus. Yeah, Faustina.
Yeah, I thought we could see Faustina, so.
Look at that.
Isn't that a coincidence? Our friend found one today yesterday.
Wow.
I'm
just to the face there.
Shocked.
That is going to clean up absolutely beautifully. Yeah, go on.
And what way up is it? That way up?
Yeah, let me see
that. Yeah,
yep. See someone standing up there. And the right around the edge. Look at that.
I'm so happy with that. Oh. That was a 70 for all you Deus fans. I'm on the 12 kilohertz.
There's me saying, it's got to be here. I found, you know, the pottery and I found the tiles.
Yeah, you carry on finding me the pottery and then I'll concentrate on your area.
God, it's always you, isn't it, eh? It's always you. Lucky cow.
Oh, you know, I'm not so good at finding pottery. I'll come and help you find coins because you can't find them.
Oh, that was my line as well. I'll give you that line. Right, it's got to be some more.
We're going to carry on gridding, even though it's raining like mad. We're going to carry on gridding.
Come on. Righto, well done. Righto, we've come out for a little morning session.
Yeah.
Had a drop of rain, so it's livened the ground up a bit.
It's much easier to dig now.
And he's already called me over. He's had a hammered.
Yeah.
And it looks like it's still in the clod. It's folded and it's still in the clod. So if we have a look.
So I reckon it's probably an Edward, but you can't really tell from a clod shot, so.
Yeah, I can see it clearly in the, and looks like it's folded.
Yeah.
It's definitely there. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so. It's definitely silver.
Yeah.
Looks hammered. Don't think it's milled.
It's definitely hammered.
So, righto, it's
get it out.
Let's see what it is when you get it out of the mud.
Yeah. Okay. Right. Get up slowly.
Hold on, let's just focus a bit.
It's definitely hammered though, it's not milled, I don't think.
No, it looks hammered to me.
Yeah. Be careful.
It's coming apart.
Yeah.
You see, even though it said rain, the ground's still...
still wet. Well, it's not really dry anymore. It's still pretty wet.
It's a fair size hammered, that.
Yeah. Full coin, I'd say.
Yeah. Looks nice.
Yep. Cool.
What do you reckon it is?
That's an Edward penny.
I think it's an Edward penny.
See the long cross.
Let's have a look.
That.
It's hard to see because it's quite bright in the sunshine. Yeah. So. But yeah, I can see some detail on there.
Yep.
And you say it looks like a full penny as well, so even better.
Well, you're going to have to straighten
it a
bit.
That's
a bit of a job. But. Yeah. That looks
honestly, I mean, it's
very nice.
It's bent, but it's not like a real sharp crease in it. So should better with a bit of heat, warm that up and
looks
strain
like
it out.
Good silver as well, not crappy silver.
That's nice.
Yeah, nice. Lovely coin that.
Let's have a look. I'm trying to see it over the top of the camera.
Not reflecting too much, is it?
No, it looks good. So it's a little bit.
I'd say it's definitely an Edward the First.
Yeah, you can see the voided. Not void, is it? It's a long,
just a normal
cross. Just a long cross, yeah. So
12 pellets.
And on the other side?
Got the mud off. It's that way. You can see his bust there.
Let's have a look. It's going to zoom in a bit.
Because it's folded, you can't really see it at the moment, but it's definitely all there. It's not worn at all, not that I can see.
Yeah, I can see the detail. It looks nice. Can you see a mint or anything on the other side?
Let's look a bit closer. Civi, Taz, Ville, it looks like a V, VI, what's Ville?
Ville?
Ville something, I can't.
So it would be a Ville Khaleesi for Calais, but I don't think he'd done Calais, so it would be a Ville.
Might not be a V.
Like Bury St Edmunds.
Yeah.
Or...
It's kind of hard to tell at the moment, but it's still a stunning coin though. A nice full coin.
That's not bad, is it?
No, not at all.
10 minutes.
Yeah. Very happy with that.
That's a cracker.
Yeah. Nice.
Can't moan at that.
Nope, not at all.
Well, I reckon we need to carry on.
Yeah, definitely.
Hopefully it'll be my turn next.
Wow, fantastic.
Well done, mate.
Anyway, yeah.
Let's keep at it. Yeah. Okay, he's called me over. Yeah. He's only had another one. And he reckons he's a cut half, so...
A bit more agey then.
Bit of an older coin, let's have a look.
Older than Edward I, definitely.
Let's see what he's got.
So,
it's definitely a cut half, look, you can see that. Let's just get closer.
You can see the voided long cross. So...
Yeah.
I mean, this is promising. I mean, it's showing there's a lot more...
Well, that's Henry...
12.72 No,
that's 12... Edward I.
12.36 to
12.72,
I guess.
Something like that, yeah. Well, the voided long cross, if it's long cross, was about 12.50 something, 12.52, 12.72.
So that's much older than an Edward I.
Something like that. So, which is good. Shows a bit of age on this field.
Yeah. Yeah, you can see it clearly there now.
Yeah, why? Because when it's wet, it's too reflective for me. Dry it off a bit.
Right, you can clearly see the voided long cross.
Yeah, so.
So.
Yeah, we'll see that.
That's fantastic.
Can you flip it over?
Might need a bit of a clean that size.
So let's just hold it still. See the hair curls?
Yeah. Oh, well.
Yeah, very nice, mate.
Doing very well today.
So, well done, mate. We'll keep gritty. You never know, might even get something even older.
Yeah.
So, well done, mate. Let's keep going.
Okay, I've just been called over by Liam. We're on a different day today, different dig.
Yeah, on my rally UK dig today.
I'm trying to shoot it from the wind as best I can. It's very windy, so I apologise if you can hear the wind.
We're out in the open quite a bit at the moment, but I've been...
Massive field.
Just striding along this field, this huge field, and this just popped up. I believe it's a heraldic pendant. I'm not quite sure, but...
Turn it around a little bit closer.
I saw this bit in the mud and I thought, oh, it's probably a piece of crap. I popped it out and then this bit come out. So I think usually they just get this bit and they don't have this top bit, but it swivels around as well.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
But if you look closely, you can see the fleur-de-lis is on there. It's fleur-de-lis, I believe, so...
That's beautiful.
That is stunning. That's my first. If it is a heraldic pendant.
Made it worth coming.
So, yeah, fantastic. I am really pleased with that. There's not much on the other side at the moment, but...
It's really nice. I'll be chuffed if I've heard that.
I'm pleased with that. So, yeah, that's a nice find there. Let's run around this area and hopefully find some hammered.
Hopefully.
So let's carry on.
Okay, Liam's just called me over. We're out today on a rally of sorts. Yeah. And he said, oh, I've found something. We've only been here 20 minutes.
I'll take it for sure. So it's a silver milled coin. As you can see, there's a hole in it. So someone's obviously made it into a necklace or some kind of jewellery type. The reverse is actually quite nice in detail.
It is, yeah.
But if you flip it over, unfortunately they've worn it down. If you can see, they've wrote like their initials or something, CR.
Yeah.
So, some sort of personal item of jewellery.
definitely.
But that's an interesting find, that. It's still nice. So, yeah, a bit of silver. I'll take that for sure.
Well done, Liam.
So, anyway, let's carry on. See if we can get any more.
Absolutely.
Okay, so now to get on to the description part of the video. As you can see, we have a lot of finds to get through. So, let's get started. Okay, so starting off, we have an Edward IV groat. It is a Bristol mint and it dates between 1466 to 1467. We can see the 12 pellets and the cross on the reverse side, and around the first ring of writing we can see Ville Bristow for Bristol mint. We can also see a crown mint mark at the top there, which also corresponds to when it was made. If we flip it over onto the obverse side, we can see Edward IV's bust facing towards us, a B on his chest, which obviously corresponds to the mint, and we also can see quatrefoils at his neck, and also the crown mint mark there again on this side also. So as can be seen earlier within the video, I had this really beautiful Saxon coin. It was really dirty and muddy, but I could tell that it would clean up a beauty, and so it has. It is fantastic. It is a Harthacnut dual cross penny, which dates between 1035 to 1036 AD. On the reverse side, we can see the letters NE, so that's the last letters of the moneyer's name. The moneyer is Leofwine, and then you can see ON, Leofwine on, and then if we just turn it around a bit further, DOF for Dover Mint. So you can see the dual cross there. It hasn't been affected by the crack there, so that is fantastic. Although it is broken, you can still see practically all of the coin. However, if we flip it over onto the obverse side, we can see Harthacnut's bust there facing left, and then we can read around the edge ARD for harder, and then around this side we can read the CN of the Canut. So this is an absolutely fantastic coin and my first Saxon hammered penny. Next up, we have an Elizabeth I sixpence, which dates to 1568, as you can clearly read above the shield there. It has a crown mint mark, which also corresponds to the date it was made. It has slight wear on the portrait side, on the obverse, as you can see there. But overall, it's still got some really nice detail and is a fantastic coin. You can see the rose behind the head there as well, which obviously means that it is a sixpence. And overall, it's a really fantastic coin, despite it being clipped and slightly worn. So one of the coins which I found within the video is an Edward I penny, which dates from 1272 to 1307. As you can see, we can see his bust there facing towards us, and we can read Edward around the edge. If we flip it over onto the reverse side, we can see the standard 12 pellets and the cross, and around the edge it reads Ville Ski Edmundi for Bury St Edmunds Mint. So overall, a fantastic coin, although it's broken slightly around the edge and slightly worn, it's still a full and very nice coin. And also found on the same day was this Henry III voided long cross cut half found by me. It dates from 1236 to 1272. You can see the six pellets and the voided long cross there. Around the edge you can read TED for Ted, so it would have been San Ted, which stands for Bury St Edmunds Mint. And you can also read ION for Ion, which corresponds to the moneyer, which is John. So overall, on the reverse, it's a very nice coin with a lot of detail there. And around the obverse side, we can see the bust, or half of the bust, of Henry III with his long curls there. And around the edge, you can read Henricus. So a coin which was seen earlier in the video and found by my mum, which is absolutely stunning, is this Faustina II Denarius. It dates between 147 and 150 AD and is in very fine condition. As you can see Faustina II with a draped bust facing right, and around the edge you can read Faustina. If we flip it over onto the reverse side, we can see Letitia standing left holding a wreath and scepter. So overall, that is an absolutely beautiful coin and I would have loved to have found it. But anyway, let's carry on. So another coin which I found within the video is the Charles II Scottish 8th dollar. As you can read at the top there, it states 1677 for the date, and what makes this coin unusual from other Charles II coinage is the thistles in each quadrant, which therefore means that it is a Scottish coin. If we flip it over onto the other side,
Unfortunately, the bust has been worn out heavily. We can sort of see the outline there at the top of his head. However, the initials that have been scratched into the coin are CR. So it could stand for Charles, referring to the coin, or it could refer to the owner's name. But overall, it's still a really interesting and personal find that has obviously been made into some kind of pendant. So I'm really chuffed with that. It's a fantastic little item. So another really interesting find, which I found within the video, is a medieval heraldic pendant which dates to the 13th century. This personal coat of arms belonged to Adam de Cokefield, and the coat of arms itself consists of six fleur-de-lis in a triangle kind of formation. It's still got the hanger there, and it can swivel around freely, so overall that is a really fantastic find. So next up, we have a 1st to 2nd century unclassified bow brooch of the Roman period. It is, well, as you can see, very elaborate. It's got some really strange details on it. We've got trefoil kind of knobs here on the end. We've got two semicircular kind of discs, and then 3x3 sort of pillars that have been, well, probably broken and would have had these trefoils on them at some point. But overall, it is a really stunning Roman brooch. It's still got the clasp here that would have caught the pin that is unfortunately broken off. But overall, that is a crazy find. And at the moment, it's unclassified. I mean, there are no other examples that has this kind of formation on it. So it's kind of unique at the moment. So overall, that is stunning. My mum is so lucky to have found this. But yeah, what a fantastic little find that is. Well, I hope you have enjoyed today's video. If you have, please remember to leave a like, comment and subscribe on the video because it really means a lot. Thanks for watching. I'm sorry that this video took so long to make. I've been very busy with college stuff and A-levels. But nevertheless, I'm going to carry on uploading and hopefully get some more videos up soon. Anyway, thank you for watching and I'll catch you in the next video.